Hey guys, I'm Yilmaz Gawash, because today I will make a little video detailing the work on this F10 2013 F10 535. I will change the flex disc or gibbo, however you want to call it, and the rear differential mount, because that's cracked as it is with most F10s on the F1, F2, around 60 to 80,000 miles. Just happens, it's part of it, just has to be changed, and I'm doing it myself because I am a trained BMW mechanic. I know what I'm getting myself into, I know it will not be fun, and I would have to just give it away to someone, but I couldn't really find a reliable shop to do it. Last time this car was in the shop, it returned with half the screws of the undermount cover missing and a dent in the rear quarter panel. It's not gonna go there again, even though it is a highly rated BMW only shop here in LA. I could also give it just to a BMW authorized dealer and have it fixed there. However, my wife's car is still at a shop at a world famous BMW dealership here in Los Angeles for the last 1.5 years. Why they painted it more than 10 times and the car will still go back to the manufacturer as soon as we get it. I'm probably gonna make another video about it and link it in the description below or here, wherever, once I make that video. It's gonna be a fun story, but not today. I'm doing this myself also because I couldn't really find any videos explaining how to do these jobs. So, changed into something more uncomfortable, checked her up, and it is hard sweating, but let's take a look at it. So, here we have the parts. This is the rear diff mount. This is the big one on the rear side of the axle carrier. That's the screw going into the M14. These two are for the smaller mounts on the front of the carrier. We also replace them. And this is the gibbo flex disc. And all screws come new because they're stretch screws and the center sleeve. Let's go take a look what I got myself into. This is the mount discussion. You can maybe see it up here a little bit. Let me zoom in. It is cracked. That's why you see it on top. Sausage finger finds its way in. Cracked up here. Once you get it out, you'll probably see it a little bit better. Oh yeah, clear. Okay, this one has to be replaced. I wanted this one replaced, right? Then I checked with shops. And some said, sure, and if you're in, since you're already in there, let's also do the two at the front. Somewhere up there, there's one here. Oh, this one here. This is one, and there's the other one. Which they look fine, at least to my assessment so far, and usually they're not a problem, it's just the one at the back that's a problem. But since I'm already in here, I wanted this one replaced because you can see the crack. This is your gibbo or flex disc. And for some reason, even though they tried to quote me for this, let's do this right away. But this one is extra, even though the same part comes out. But to me that's... anyway, let's not say it. Yeah, that's the scope of this video today. And the problem is, as you can see, the stiff is in the way. I have to lower that. This may be a problem, this exhaust is a problem. Let's take a look. So, exhaust. This is not a stock exhaust, we have a mount here. And then there's one here. You can either just out or unscrew these ones here, or just push these out. This one, probably just unscrew them, and that's the end of it. This is a hex one, but this is a Torx out here. So, yeah, don't unscrew them. We'll see. Yeah, both sides the same. This one, this bar you can leave.
have another one here. This is original. That's how it looks like. Probably just pull this one out. But. Oh, look at that. But yeah, you can see that the entire exhaust mount here is connected to the rear div. We're putting this out first, and then later on this comes off. Heat shield has to go, exhaust has to go. This is your resonator, in case you want to delete that. Good luck with that. I heard it doesn't do a lot. This plate here has to go. For this one I used the old screws. And I hope I don't have to take off the exhaust, because it goes all the way. Oh yeah, that's where it ends. Ooh. I might have to, I do not want to, because I know usually these come out pretty shitty. See you. Little shit. Mentioned I just pulled this mount out and screwed this down. This is a Torx, I don't have a Torx, I used a 8mm. Yeah, 8mm and 13 back here if it is. Now I'm gonna lower this entire thing and off we go. This is all it gave me. This is all it gave me. So after assessing the situation, and I have to still lower the diff, your diff won't come down too low. Look at that. How should I work in here? Don't. So, exhaust has to go. So there you go. That's the exhaust. This is not original. Looks like fairly customized. Yeah, that came like that. Resonator. Did. Not much on that. Catalytic converter is still on there. Resonator. And these parts. Let's take a look underneath. Heat shield. Take that out. It's easy now. Nothing in the way. We only do that so we can lower the drive shaft with that with the rear differential, have more space and access the screws for or bolts for the gibbo flexes.
So I had some fun with the no exhaust setup. I'm gonna put a link for that in the description or somewhere on the screen. Now we're gone. This one has to go. This heat shield, this is a rear axle here, as you see. We just open these screws, but don't take it out all, just open it, so I can then pull out this one here. This will give me all the space to lower the diff. So, are you finally getting closer? You can see this disc is done. It's actually worse than I thought it is, but these cracks are not okay. We have this bolt here. This one here, these are the front mounts, or the mounts towards the front of the rear diff in the rear axle carrier. And this boy here, just as the rear one, we're gonna tension this one. Yeah, I'm just gonna open these three, drag the diff up, kind of somewhere here, and then slowly lower it. The critical point is to not have too much stress on the drive shafts when they contact with the axle carrier here. So
And then I should have enough space. I can see that to work on there. And we place this mount. And once I do that, I will come back here this to this one and to place this one. So let's get started. So this just happened. Didn't fit snug, now it's kinda round. Kinda sucks. Turned out to be a 3/8. I used a 10mm because it's a German car. Should work, didn't work, so 3/8 does the trick on these ones. This one trick came too late, so now I'm taking out the hammer and try to slap some grip on it. So now that everything in the way is to the side, you can see, you get a clear view onto the front mounts for the differential, and they look perfectly fine. So why I got quoted? I think DC place is a mystery to me, but how this one could be ignored by three shops is as well a mystery to me. All these screws are open and loosened, of course they still hold. We also have this one repaired and the one at the rear. Now it's time to lower the diff. I live inside my own world of make-believe. Kids screaming in the cradles, profanities. I see the world through ice covered in ink and bleach. Cross out the ones who heard my cries and watched me weep. I love everything. So once you lowered the winter, you don't have to lower the lot. In fact, you don't want to. Up there's the mount we're gonna change. You don't want to lower it so much that you will touch your wings. What do you want to call it? And we want to keep the drive shafts clear. Same up here, you can see right now. You don't want to contact it. And now I'm just gonna use the special tool you have to get to pull. God bless it. To pull the mount from this side towards the front. That's how you put it out, but first you're gonna use some WD-40. Just let some oil sink in between the ribs, so it comes out a little easier. So here's our special toolkit. This is what it looks like. It's all the tools you need to put it out and push it back in. So this is the new mount, pushing whatever. And the reason I was spraying some oil in there is because you have little grooves in here. So the oil may run in between and may make it a little easier for us to get it out. Now choosing the right tool to put it out, it's easy. This is the body, fills in here, so and this is the one to push it out. It's numbered, right? For this set, it's you need 1, 3, and 1, 2, and 3. We'll see that number 3, this tool is gonna push on the outside of the wing and push the bearing straight through, and you just catch it with this container. Installing it, we'll use different tools. We'll use 4 and 5, other way around. 5 will push the new bearing in. Scoop it out. So you will push it in until it's flush on the body, then it has the right depth. And this will be on the other side to push, to hold against the axle carrier and give it space so it fits in. Pretty straightforward. Just go ahead, get it started. Clovers in my locket, untied laces.
just tripping on day. Dreams got dirty little lullabies playing on repeat. Might as well just rot around the nursery and count sheep. So, got it out finally. It's the old one. You can clearly see the cracks. This is one that's almost all the way through. Can see it coming here. I've seen worse ones, but still, time to change it. The little dot goes to the bottom because you can see this was on the top. Same goes this to the top. You also have this little groove in here as an indicator to install it properly. Let's try these three. You can clearly see the groove lines. And before installing the new one, we'll use some brake cleaner and some sandpaper to clean this out, make it a little more smooth. So now that the differential is in its place again, it's time to torque the bolts that hold it in place. I will start with the one at the rear side of the vehicle. This one here. This one will be torqued with 175 Newton meter. That's about 130 foot pound. And the two in the front, the smaller ones, this one and this one over there, they will each be torqued with 100 Newton meter and 90 degree angle. So I will show you what that means. 100 Newton meter is about 75 foot pound, and then you get the angle 90 degree. So basically what it is, you just torque it with 100 Newton meter, and then you spin it, you tighten it another 90 degree. So I decided to not do 100 Newton meter and 90 degree on the smaller mount bolts, because based on my experience, this is tight. That's not gonna come off. And I'm concerned that there may be some damage that I over tighten them. And I'm gonna damage the actual differential which the bolts go into. So, it's not gonna fall out, it's tight. Do it with 100 Newton meter, maybe 110, that's plenty. And you will see that you won't be able to turn it much more than that. So continuing, transmission, the rear differential is in there again. It's all tightened up. Now just continue and change the flex disc. Yep, for the flex disc, this one had to come off because the board will show you. So the issue with the flex disc, it's all loose, but you can see there's like a centering sleeve in there. And even though you can push this to the front of the car a little bit, it's not going to give you enough space to take it out. So you have to lower it on the center joint, this one here. You open these two probably 13 millimeter screws and lower this entire drive shaft. Of course you had to take off the heat shield first. What I'm gonna do now, that should give me enough space to take this apart here, change the disc and also the centering sleeve. So, here you have it. This is new, this is old. You see these cracks, right? Wow, it's a bad one. Just look at it. How can you say, yeah, this one is still fine? First side looks very same, looks very similar. It's the same. We have these little marks on here. It's important to watch them so it fits. Basically, it's showing the direction of the flange. So, 1, 3 here. 1, 2, 3 is for the drive shaft. The other three also have arrows pointing in a different direction. The
arrow basically points towards the either drive shaft or the differential where it is mounted. So let's go ahead and drop it in and tighten it. You have also seen how I've been marking the center bearing because it has some pretension on it. So I just go back and push it to the markings I made. That should be it. Go. That's how you change your rear differential, rear bushing or mount, call it whatever you want, this guy. And since you're in there, I would recommend also changing your flex disc right away. You're in there, just do it. Because you see all the cracks it has. Just take a look. Wow. The car is now 64,000 miles. So it's not that far, not that many miles, but you see these, right? Yeah, it's very deep. Yep, this is not a lot. I got both all my parts from BMW Atlanta. They give you also a discount on it, you order online. It's all the original BMW car parts, even the bolts. Yeah, this one you torque, the screw for this one, or the bolt for this one, the top gear 175. For the two smaller one, I only went with 110. I didn't trust the information I had, but it will not fall out. All six for these, you torque with 55 newton meter and 90 degree. I hope it comes across on the video. That's it. It's gonna slap on the exhaust again, and then that's it. And yes, of course, I did a sound check without the exhaust. It's gonna be a different video. I'm gonna link that in the description below. Yeah, it sounds pretty awesome. So if you decide to do that, no matter what it is, 528, 550, M5, it'd be awesome. Once you have the exhaust off, just make a clip about it. Everybody likes it. Thanks for watching. Bye.